Welcome back, everybody, here to our semi-final. It is Viva City going up against Absolute Legends here in the semi-final. We've been stalking Absolute Legends our entire night almost here for the 4PL, and, kind of worth it, too. They've been having some really solid games. Sometimes it's been standard kind of play, but you know what? Maybe something different might be awaiting us here right now. Maybe. I don't know. We'll find out together, peoples, together. We shall hold hands and jump through parsley fields. But we'll see Viva City banding out, Batrider as well as the Darkseer. Absolute Legends. Still haven't changed all their bloody names. But it will be Nyx as well as Wisp being banned out by the man who wants to be known as Strandby. Divot. I have his name here from before. So give me a moment. David is Ryze, and it's Miguel who is Strandby doing the draft. So that is our lineup of Absolute Legends. Sidra being the stand-in this evening. So Absolute stand-ins up and ready to rock and rumble. And again, we see Keeper of the Light with a Gyro and a Bane. Strong already from Viva City. Really, really strong. The T5 potential of them is just so great. Even if there is a Magnetor on the field for Absolute Legends, between a Keeper of the Light as well as a Gyro, you basically control everywhere. Everywhere in a team fight. And then you have a Bane, and still, Miguel wants to pick up that Nyx. Even with the Bane on the field, they don't care about the Bane. They just want to keep rocking and rolling. And that also, it supposed to won't really matter either. Like, Mag comes out during the middle of a team fight and goes, "Hey, what's up? Reverse polarity. Snake's inside me. I pop out, do a whole bunch of damage. There's so many units going pop, 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 pop all the way around. The chance of Bane being able to hit his Fiend script correctly during the engagement drops significantly." So the problematic Bane ulti will be an interesting thing to watch. We'll see if he's also going to get hunted. I'm expecting somebody to be out there looking for the Bane. Some hero that's able to jump through the rear. Nyx has already panned out. Who else would there be? There'd be Klinks, and there would be Bounty Hunter. Offlane hero possibility. Up against a Gyro, though, Bounty won't want to come in that close at any point of the game. And he may not... actually, may not worry about it. 10 seconds. Because by the time he gets to that point, he should have enough farm up. Because I'm feeling right now from Viva City. 5 seconds. Bane remaining. And Coddle and Gyro. It reeks of aggressive try. At least reeks of checking out the Radiant Jungle at the very, very start. Absolute Legends first round fight, not as strong. Not yet. We'll see what else there is. For them, they started to hit their strides a little bit later on once the level 6s start to pop off for both Rubick as well as Mag. Our bans start coming the way, Viva City, so they take out junglers, Nature's Prophet, take out the Enchantress, and also take out a Weaver. Weaver has been running on the offlane a lot. There's not any kind of lockdown stuns apart from Fiendscript to hold Weaver in position. And they want to have that for Nyx. Weaver would just time-lapse out if anything else was thrown. Be it Barrage, be it whatever. That missile from Gyro won't lock her down enough. And most of the Gyros we've seen earlier tonight haven't even leveled up their rocket until both Flat Cannon as well as Rocket Barrage were maxed. Well, there goes Quap. So that's indication that that'll be a Mag in the middle lane. Queen of Pain is normally the worst hero you can have up against a Magnetor. Horrible lane to play in. Horrible, horrible lane to play in if you're the Mag. And with the PL as well as the lone Druid taken out, stops the overall push and then the problem of the entangles, and also stops the possibility of Cancer Lancer. AL fourth pickup. Last support hero I feel coming out though. Keep their mid solo just a little bit not known. Beastmaster is up for Viva City, but we don't know where he's going to end up. He could be off lane. 10 seconds remaining. He could be safe lane on bot up against a Mag. He could be solo mid up remaining. Against the Mag. More than likely that one. Which means all we're waiting for right now from Viva City is a hero like maybe like a Luna who's pulled a couple of extra resources. Get those two rings of protection up early, so you can go yourself into the Ring of Basilius, silencer. As well as, ooh, I like, But yeah, you can have Ring of Basilius. Oh, that makes her a very, very fun, aggressive tri lane. Warlock is the final one. Mid solo only. Mid solo only hero. Which means Beastmaster would be on that bottom lane or up on the top lane. And then Bane, Coddle, and Gyro somewhere together. Laugh if Bane heads mid, and it's meant to be a Coddle and Warlock combination up on the top. Interesting combination, but Warlock has only been running the solo mid these days. But unknown teams, you never know what's coming.
Remaining.
So what's our last one?
5 seconds remaining.
When are you gonna give us, Miguel? You've already picked up the silencer.
Reserve time.
Need one more stable hero and see which lanes they want to run on. Because if it is gonna be Nakes combining up with Rubick on that top lane to push the silencer into the mid mag on the long lane, but that's not really gonna work for them. Sand King pickup. Okay, we're looking aggressive again. Be it Rubick solo mid or not, Cinderin again up on that Nakes. Mag could be going on the long lane, but his biggest problem is going to be the insanely short skewer. And then Viva City just able to control and lock him down. And that'll be what he's mainly going to be concerned about. But we'll wait and see. We shall wait and see. So everyone, almost everyone, Absolute Legends, the slowest ones of all, to pick up their last hero. But I want to see these lanes. Give me my item builds.
Remaining.
10 seconds announcer. That's too long. I'm not happy with 10 seconds.
5 seconds
I want it now.
Remaining.
5 seconds? Still too long. There we go. Fantastic. All right, in the game. So let's look at our builds. Mag, built to do it tough. 6 tangos, 1 salve, as well as a stout shield. Could be going solo up on that top lane. Cinderin, also similarly built. So then, if I say that, what else have we got? We got sentries, we got observers. Okay, Mag heading down bottom lane. Miracle, bottle run for the solo mid. And that leaves Ryze, as well as Miguel. They'll be supporting on that top lane in combination with Cinderin. And going up against what? We'll have Judo on the bottom lane. Ring of Protection to start with. Tangos. Main thing from here, this will probably, well, this definitely will be his Tranquil Boots. And just trying to stay alive in that bottom lane up against the Mag. Which gives us a aggressive tri lane up on top. Bane already walking around with smoke. River City. 1 salve. Interesting that he goes to salve instead. Most people who go in towards that middle lane don't really want to fall back from the lane too long. So what they normally do is have tangos. So they can still stay on the front lines and still get those last hits without having to worry about being further back and worrying about the salve being triggered so it doesn't work. Normally the case. Keep it light. Now the ward's couple of clarities. Already looking with extra consumables put in here, life consumables, that he is looking to do it rough up on the top. And they'll always just pull them around. Sentry wards, that's going to be mainly for wards just like this one. Except they'll probably throw the sentry ward here inside the lane. Because they want to look for the ward on the lane itself. But this ward's actually a really nice position. Sees deeper in. Watches the transition up from the river. Watches this little path in here. So anything which crosses this line is known. And they've already got one other ward, which is watching at the top of the pit. So there's only basically one way to get up right now. Actually, no, there's not even that. Because you're still going to be spotted as you come up this ramp. So there's no way to enter Aeol's jungle unless you go through the bottom rune and then cut across here. But then again, you get spotted. So, not gonna happen. Nope, Nightmare on Ryze. Turned off. Down half life. Nice Burrow Strike. Gonna go through too. And now running for the regen. Yeah, the attacks will fly. There's not gonna be enough for regeneration. Needs one more hit to kill him off. And Cobble's got it. Nice salve. And then Blast. Can't escape from that. Short chain as well. Only just had enough to throw that out. And then the curses begin. I think he's just wearing this out. He can pop off that Shadow Word if he wants to, but he's taking some damage first. But it's going to be a solo mid-silencer. Ryan's coming in to make sure he's going to be okay. Down the bottom lane. Gyro up against a mag. I wish you all the best of luck there, Miguel. All the best of luck. Well, Sidra's going to have a great time up on top. Beastmaster comes in close. Not a problem at all. If he's got one or two heroes supporting him up, one hero, maybe kill. Two heroes, definite kill. Oh, this is going to be frustrating the crap out of Miracle. He's got to keep these abilities spamming out. Got to keep that Curse of the Silent going. He's already picked up the one extra point in Glaives. Okay, so let's see. Maybe a kill. Guess only one hero support to come in. No, forcing him back off the lane. And that is all. We'll ever see. Already that bottle flying out. So, Brain, I'm going to have his courier bottle on the way. It looks like Miracle also hit the same. So, bottle's flying out for him too. Just becomes a trade-off at the end of the day. Who can force out the most amount of mana? Always about to hit. Keeping him low and the curse hit. Man, that's a lot of damage. That is really a lot of damage when you think about it. The Miracle knows he can spam it because now his bottle arrives. 2 minute rune control. And it's controlled by Ryze. Sorry, not by Ryze. What am I talking about? That's Mania. Mania, Miguel, Miracle, Ryze, Syndrome. Yes. Gotta keep that in the mind. Illusion rune dive. Maybe, maybe. Catch out that Beastmaster. He's only level 2, so it shouldn't be too hard. Open wounds. Opens up. Large amount of lifesteal for Syndrome. Fire strike as well, so no timing for the axes there. They were thinking about getting that last hit over to him, but not going to be possible. At the same time, Mag dies in the bottom lane. So it's a trade either way. The only difference is there's going to be more experience given towards that bottom lane. The bigger thing is, Mag at least has almost 4 levels up, where the Beastmaster is sitting at 2 and 3rd. So, not great. This harassment of spell battle. Fatal Bonds! Curse of Silent! Fatal Bonds! Curse of Silent! But there's always one person that has to have the last word. Oh, so lame. Oh, where's Mag headed? Stopping the extra pull. Just body blocking him out for now. And then a shockwave. Even looking to steal some of the farm. At least still got the pull done. The shockwave brought the creep wave up. LOL. Mag. Kind of would like to get that perfect skewer up this direction. But not possible anymore. You can't throw them up here. Well, it was only telekinesis that stopped that from happening. No, I think they actually fixed the cliffs. That cliff right there. You can't throw people up here anymore. Be it through skewer or be it through other things. And Beastmaster still wants to get close enough to find some level of experience. Hiding in the tree line is probably the only way he'll do it. And there's level 3, so Hawk, at least he'll see if he's going to get ganked from the side, but he's also being watched. That Dire Ward hasn't gone yet. And then Ryze, with the quickly feet, going to run in behind. Trying to wait for Warlock to spam something out. And there goes Shadow Ward, and he's already used his Fatal Bonds. So Miracle being forced back a little bit further than he would have liked. But it's okay for him. He just bottles up and feels good about life. Top gank again, Ryze. Well, he's just behind the tower. But there's no illusion runes of SK this time around. And I think Beastmaster feels it. He would have seen him. One observer ward here from the Radiant side, keeping tabs on it all. Same time, Mag again on the bottom lane. Not even requiring a level 6 from Bane to do that. And Ryze needs a pickup and throwback. Telekinesis? Nope. Just wants to force him off. And they'll see if they can bring down the creep wave first. And then Coddle Blast. Stops all forms of thoughts of push. And this bottom lane for Mag is... Well, it's not working for so many heroes. Beastmaster hasn't got a single Larson up on this top lane. See him hurling out the axes right now. He's being denied north front lines. There you go, one. First last hit. 5 minutes and 47 seconds. And we get the first last hit in. We're on the bottom lane, at least Mags managed to achieve some last hits. 9-for-1. They're trying to pick up that 6 minute rune. Not there. Invis on the top. Get Miracle there right now. It's going to be too late. Gotta pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And now pick him up. Maybe that would have been the better choice. Pick him up, not the rune. It's only a level 1 telekinesis. But it might have been able to bump him up. I think this was the other cliff which was you couldn't throw him up on. But this one still works, I believe. I only tested out in the bottom cliff, that's why I don't know. Well, pick up, throw down. Miracle. There goes your last word. Wow. Throw down the rock for that one. Miracle needs another extra hit. Oh, get away from the rock. Get away from the rock, Miracle. You got no extra life points. And that last word didn't pop him off. And that Cotter Blast was hoping someone would still be there. Meanwhile, Tier 1 tower being brought down slowly by Syndra. 44 for 13. Wants to focus on the tower, but if he attacks it anymore, it brings him into deny range. Hey, he's got siege creeps coming in. Forces off the fortification. And then Coddle. It's a level 1 Illuminate. It's going to do nothing to him. Okay, a little bit to him. But not enough to make him worry. SK takes the last hit. Syndra's already running ahead of Myers and got 1k goals. Now he'll finally buy boots. Maybe finish up that magic wand he started ages ago. Okay, he started the game. Miracle gets his treads up, so Intel treads for him. Oh, still Flaming Rock. Kind of helps Mania, Miracle out a little bit more. Pushes the creep wave away from the tier 1 tower, so easier for him to farm. And then one creep left behind, so not as easy. Right, Syndra, it's almost like he's waiting for a reason to infest. Hand of Midas the ball. No slow for you. How's Jaro doing? 47 for 14, Ring of Aquila, Phase Boots. Looking pretty good down there. Should we get the drums at a nice timing as well? And also be very well prepared to do a lot of damage to that tier 1 tower on the bot lane. Yeah, curse you. Only 3 tethered now through the Fatal Bonds. Possibility of 6, but he did it so early on that the new creep wave hadn't arrived yet. But he did it just so he got rid of the curse. The curse of the people who just do nothing. It's like Campus Curse. Imagine you can have that in an FPS. What do? Someone just sits in the corner. They can't fire for 5 seconds and they take damage the entire time. Yep. Actually, no, that was done in Counter-Strike. Oh, I remember I played a mod. I played a mod and it was in Counter-Strike. And you took damage if you were caught being a camper. For all those people out there, it's like to sit back with like those wonderful like sniper rifles. Just go with the orb. Yep. Never even have to move. Wait, no, I have to move. Because the silent forces you to play. Sometimes, though, he's a mean bastard. He's forcing you to play, but making you stop as well. Because then you've got the global silence duration of 4 seconds. And then you've also got the silence disarm duration of 6 seconds. So basically, you're stopped from doing anything for 10 seconds, and the curse of the silent affects you for 6 seconds. Yeah, go figure. Go figure. Oh, Rock gonna drop down again. Rise. Man, what he would give to be level 6 right now. Nice curse too. Trying to get close enough for a photo bonds, isn't he? Or something. No? Doesn't tick down enough of him. With the Flaming Rock in the mid, this mid lane's a little bit more trickier now. Especially with Coddle Blast coming. Fade Block can push the creep way back a little bit. Take off the damage of the rock, so the tower doesn't take as much. But it basically means Rubik's out. He's got nothing left to give. He's not level 6 just yet. That was actually SK. He's managed to find himself level 6 with Arcane Boots. Mag is going to be very happy with that. But we'll look for the Burrow Strike into the Epicenter, realizing the rock is down. So the only stun of Warlock is gone. So they can't interrupt the Epicenter once it gets channeled. But reveals the fact that he's there with the Observer Ward in the mid. gyro hanging on the bot. Strangby still wants to make a play. See him just sitting back, waiting for that right opening. And Beastmaster. At least he's almost found that level 6. But not before Mag. Mag stacking up the jungle, just farming it up. Because he's running his own bottle. Gotta line that shockwave up a little bit better. And also get back in here before these creeps regenerate. Thing called a Satter, man. These guys heal. And then they're dead. 1.1k. Go get your arcanes. Yup, collect your prize at the door. TP scroll for Beastmaster. Once he gets that level 6, we'll probably see him go bottom lane. Help to push out that T1 tower in the bot lane. Help out the gyro. Put levels up in Beast. Only 1 point. But 2 points up in Call of the Wild instead. So the Greater Hawk. All about that vision. Got to know how far he can push it on the top lane. Nice regen route. Bottle up. Arcanes. And the Bash Brothers are going to go together. Team fight, boys, and we'll see instantly should be Warlock falling off that middle lane. Instantly should be Warlock falling off the middle lane. Yeah, there goes the ping. It's like, yo, guys. Got to move back. And then they're spotted again. So they head down towards the mid. Warlock was just going up for his point booster, so Aghanim Scepter going to be his first item of choice. And it's going to be one hell of a team fight. Not only for the fact that you can't interrupt the combination, but it's more for the fact that once the ulti, like, the ulti comes out from Silencer, you can't stop it, you can't counter-initiate. Mag will hold you there. Ryze will take a lot of your mana, and once the mag does the pickup, you're already going to have that telekinesis, so you pick up another unit, then you get another AoE stun. Then you have Curse the Sal on top of that. Then you've also got the last word, so that's going to stop Beastmaster from getting his roar off correctly. And Naxx just doesn't care. He's continuously farming up on that top lane. Doesn't need to be involved. This can be four-man Dota. That teamfight combo works without the Naxx. With the Naxx, it's also an area of effect damage, so... Well, there he comes. And he jumps up inside the Sand King. This is gonna be hell. And there's that call around. It's like, come up, loop around. Like, no, guys, it's like, push the damn tower. Who cares if we show all five down here? They probably have wards watching us anyway. Oh man, 4 TP. That's exactly what they're looking for. First hit. Now Naxx jumps out into the epicenter. Nothing can stop that. And the reverse polarity. Warlock never even got the rocks off. And now it's going to be Judo caught. Nice call down. Big damage, especially when they're taking up the tower. Double kill for the mag. And oh, really? Really? That so looked like the animation hit. Miracle can't get close enough for the curse. There he goes. Nothing else to pop. Last word and Curse of the Silent. Kicking him out, forcing him off the lane.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And Mag should feel very, very lucky that he lived through that. And the one sacrifice. The SK. Ryze got back to base. They didn't take the T1 tower, though. T1 tower still remaining up and running. Or is it that not the T1 tower they want? But look at the big man. Nope. Miracle's back into his lane. Mech should be flying out now, I assume? Yep. So mech for Miracle. Strambi with his TP, but no Blink Dagger just yet. They're already calling for him on the top lane. Difficult person to get down. They need some dust or reveal. Because all he's got to do is jump inside the sandstorm. Either jump inside the sandstorm or Warlock throws his rock to get the kill. And Warlock throwing his rock isn't worth it. For a kill on an SK, meh. Now a kill on the bottom lane. Invis jump out. Open wounds just to try and slow him down so we can't escape from this one. Called out again, gonna be turned around. Ryze, get that steal, man. No, I think he likes his 3 points up in Illuminate. Especially when someone does this. Push in, and now Illuminate. Illuminate! Rock, Illuminate already there. No steal again. Senran's on very, very low life. This Fatal Bond's not really helping out. Remember, Fatal Bond's not lost inside the Rage. He'll finish up buying his armlet. Colder Blast will fly through. He doesn't have enough damage to finish him off, and there's nothing tied with the Fatal Bonds anymore. Including Ryze. If Ryze dies now, he doesn't kill off his teammate. The Viva. Trying to look behind the towers for the kill. So Mag dies. Gyro dies. Gyro the bigger one, though. If Nakes died as well, that would have been a loss for AL. But at the end of the day, it's a win for them. Because he did not die. But with the Coddle Blast and the Rock in the front lines, pushing out these creep waves is easy enough. But anyway, what level is that blast? Still only level 3. Four points up in Chakra, and 3 points up in Illuminate. This looks to be so far behind the 8 ball. Dive it. Dive it. Dive it. Doesn't have Blink. He's got a reverse polarity in a skewer and a syndrome that's wanting to infest in 6 seconds. Oops. And then spotted. Bane just a little bit off to the corner. With the diver watching for him anyway. What they are looking for more though is up in the middle lane. So searching for Miracle. And Miracle wants to defend this mid tower. Fortifications available. And then TP, look for the curse, gets it out on the gyro to start with. Can throw off the global silence too if he so desires. Burrow strike hit by Strampy, no chain off. It's a big Coddle Blast, but then Mech allowing Miracle to survive. Not to mention, with this called out, now Miracle's dead. Fiendscript holds him in position. Then reverse polarity, 3 called out. Burrow strike to go through 4, but SK gets obliterated by the Coddle Blast. Obi-Wan Banana Nun. Able to take down the Mag with the last hit there. 3 heroes on the sidelines. Absolute legends. For the price of a gyro. And Syndra again, not involved. T1 tower on the bottom lane being brought down. For the price of a T1 in the mid as well as 3 heroes. And now TP up to the top lane. So Beastmaster back to his farming. 1100 gold for him. What's our advantage wise? It's only 3k for AL. It's almost a little bit different to what I kind of felt earlier tonight. Earlier tonight, I was like, yeah, feels okay. Feels okay. Feels actually quite okay. And then all of a sudden, it was like 10,000 gold. I'm like, whatever. But this time around, I kind of felt like AL was controlling a lot more. But they're not. The advantage does not just suggest it. The only thing it does suggest is the fact that Syndarin is rich as hell. But not as rich as the gyro. 117. Building into that BKB. Having it in 200 gold. Skewered down. Shockwave cannot finish that. He wanted the extra slow from it. So Ryze to get close enough for a pickup. Not to mention he's got Fiendscript. So he can open up on anybody. All he needs is somebody. Somebody to grip. Somebody. Somebody. Eesh. Let's not go there. We've hit that late night, guys. Sorry. Hawk having a bit of a scout around. Can perfectly see Ryze. As well as Trampy just sitting over on the sides. Bane gonna be really careful how close he gets in. Warlock now with the level 2 ultimate. And Ryze is running out of the Fiendscript. Guys, rocket. Attack the rocket. There we go. 5v5 engagement is brewing. All ulties up for everybody bar Coral. And now TP's into the middle lane. Whoop, already called out. Miracle really called out with a Fiendscript. And then Fiendscript returned to the Bane. And Epicenter, can they get off Beastmaster? No Roar thrown out just yet. In fact, he held it the entire time. And then double Rock. Ryze, Steel, he can't. 4 seconds he's got left on it. Now Nightmare up. Mag might help him out here. At the same time, where is our Nakes? It's my bigger question. Ryze, pick up, throw down, extra stun. Gonna hold at least one hero away, but that's it. And Syndarin's back at base. He wasn't involved in that, was he? Just farming up. 117. Fires like death, yeah. 105. 5 assists up his name. Doesn't really feel like it's been part of that many. Or maybe that was the problem. They haven't got kills if he hasn't been involved. So to get that stun on bottom lane. Mag never got the RP off. And now Sind. Nope, he's hunting rocks. One more hit. It's free gold, man. Free gold taken. But his teammates don't like it as much. Need to get down there and help, but Ryze comes in. Colder Blast about to come to the face. Nice curse, but then Colder Blast to the face. Nightmare trying to cancel off a little of this extra damage. He's going to be successful. And with all the urn charges he got from before, he won't really care about this amount of damage. As Sindh still continues to farm. So while Viva are all moving together as five, Sindh is still just finding this space to farm up. Building into a Desolator, which means Roshan, once it's over, once it's done. Mag finds his Blink Dagger, so the initiation now comes the way of Absolute Legends. Was this just a waiting game? Don't lose too many heroes and just play the waiting game. And they want to kill somebody. But not with that Nyx. Thesso is now done. So this is now just moving into something else. This is moving into a clearance of the Radiant Jungle. So then they can go in for Roshan. They see it's all controlled. Miracle's pushed out the bottom. One thing they didn't do, however, is bring a sentry ward. So they're being watched quite clearly here. Vision extends over. And with what they're doing, it's probably going to be rather obvious over to Viva what's going on. Yep, sending the Hawk. And you know what the Geo is. But they want to get rid of this Hawk. Blink up with the Shockwave. Roshan. He won't survive, and looks like Viva, well, they know what's going on, but they don't care. They'll go for a trade. T1 tower on the top lane taken out. Jara with more farm, 2.5k now, which means a Demon Edge for him during the next fight. It won't matter if Sindh has Desso and Armlet if he's got no life left to deal. In fact, the Aegis the Immortal was given to Miracle. He's been the man that's been focused in every single engagement. That's because Snakes hasn't been there. And now the pings are coming to the top, but still, good warding coming out from Viva. They're keeping tabs on everything across the map. At the same time, Warlock getting some really good farm. 300, and then we get ourselves three rocks falling from the skies. Almost. Need to wait until he gets up to the levels. Gets that second level up. Oh, that third level, sorry. There, we just need a refresher orb as well. No pressure, Brain. No pressure. Let's keep the light. Finding his farm too. So Mech is up for him. 1200, so can be building into that 4-star for himself now. Ghostceptor already up in the Bane, trying to avoid that Nyx at all costs. But Nyx isn't his main problem. Silence's attacks also are probably his bigger problem. His bigger problem is really the RP with the SK combo. And the initial initiation. And bottom tower denied by Nyx. Only just. Coming in close there, Sindarin. Miracle's still going to have fun up on that top lane. Up to level 12, but Gyro doesn't care about low levels. Starts with a flag cannon. It's going to clear out this top lane. A Miracle wisely so will fall back. So now they've got this Aegis the Immortal. It's like Viva don't want to initiate in. But they don't want to lose control over their lane, so they just split themselves up in their five-man Dota. This actually works better for Viva as opposed to what they're doing before. Because now they're finding levels on all these heroes. They're finding their farm. Yep, there's that Ags done. We're not going to go into the Demon Edge. We're going to get a Butterfly instead. Can't surprise about that because the amount of damage the Gyro does during the engagement sure is raised a little bit by the Butterfly. But the Monkey King bar is just one of those things that you rack up the damage even higher. And you can wipe an entire team in just a couple of moments. But you have a Butterfly on that one, it won't matter when you've got an Epicenter and an RP holding you in position. Barrow Strike under one. Does he get the rock off? No. Throws out this Global Silence just to ensure, too, that ulti doesn't come. And there's no support from anybody else. Colder Blast will still hold the mid-tower. They can't really stop that. Miracle still trying to get close enough to see if anybody is trying to. I love his build. Rod of Athos. Having trouble surviving? Not a problem. Get a Rod of Athos. Whoop! Already getting caught out. Blink Dagger's up on SK. Welcome to Initiation Central. And range initiation as well. This is dangerous, but dangerous times. T1 Town should go down here in the mid. No issue whatsoever. Even with the gyro, they won't want to defend it. And then just move back, take the Ancients, move up top, push the tier 2 tower on the top lane. Make life easy. And Cinderin with Empower too, just cleans up creep waves pretty damn fast. Get that cleave damage. It's another thing which I didn't really mention. When it comes to the team fights, Mag holds everyone in position, and with the Empower up on Cinderin, you get the cleave damage that goes through everyone that's caught in that fight. So we're looking at already the buff ups he gets and the damage. Deso and Armlin helping all out. He's got 4k gold as well. But hitting over 200 per hit. And then you've got the Sand King to come in. And the amount of pulses, damage per pulse, 110. And he's doing 10 pulses on Scepter, but right now it's 8 because he's not building Scepter. But 8 pulses worth of damage with the Epicenter, that's a lot of damage to throw out. Shockwave gets rid of the Hawk, and now they see Beastmaster. Rise. It's a good thing for him that Viva gave up on enough, the Hawk went down. Cupid's got farm, but then he sent something out. Ah, ward. And Jara almost up with that butterfly. Attacking him is still going to be difficult if they don't get the ulti combination right. Well, I was saying before, like, yay, why is he going butterfly? Evasion, yeah. But you also realize that Cinderin probably wanted to build up into a basher or something along those lines. Maybe an assault cuirass or go like he did before, which was the heart build. And it's a heart. So he gets a lot of life, but he can't attack the gyro during the engagement. So they must get their teamfight combination out in the gyro, or at least hold him in position long enough that they can make the most out of it. So Curse with the silence already. No, there is a global silence, but it was too late. The rocket already hit him. Now he needs silence. He's got two mute icons over the top of his face. Beastmaster. Hawk vision. Yep. Sees him clearly. Regen rune will get stolen. Again, we're going to see the double reverse polarity coming out from AL's Magnetor. And Cinderin, there's our heart. But they also realized the timing of that engagement. Probably another reason why they fell back. Silence the Lost is Aegis the Immortal. Reclaimed by Roshan. And a quick disconnection from SK. So, guys, just a reminder too, guys, it's our last game of the night. If you miss any of the games from today, we will be having a rebroadcast after this. So, if you are tuning in from the American time zone and you missed the games from earlier tonight, be it the first game, which was 4FC going up against No Tidehunter, I think it was. Or was that meant to be the game which was meant to happen? No Tide vs 4FC. Hey! Memory's right! So No Tide vs 4FC, Na'Vi vs TCM, and then Lions Pride vs DD. All three games we did out of the four games. Not all three, but three games out of the four of Starlight tonight will be rebroadcast directly after this game. So if you're on the live stream, stay on the live stream. You'll be able to check out those matches. So, yep, should be some good fun. Watch yourself some Na'Vi vs TCM. Also, if you missed or you don't want to wait for the rebroadcast, I will unhide the broadcasts. I think some of them have already been done over on our Twitch TV channel. Or you can go to youtube.com/joindota and you'll find all the VODs available for your viewing pleasure over there. Sorted into their different playlists so you can look at all the competitions. Any game which I broadcast out here will be over on the YouTube channel. Any official game. The Staff Cup match is only available on the Twitch TV VOD. So if you want to check that one out, you can do so. Where we beat the Russians! That's right. Whoops, sorry, spoiler alert. Missed that. Oh, well. It was posted up on Twitter. on Reddit. So I can't really help with that. And also, guys, there should be a really cool thing happening with the prize money from that one. So You'll hear more details about that in the future. But thank you very much to everyone who did post up in the Reddit thread and gave their advice what they would like to happen to the 1500 that we ended up winning from the Russians. We took them all into consideration, and we had a really awesome suggestion come in. And it's something I believe you guys can get involved into.
To you, my loyalty.
But yeah, more details about that hopefully later on in the week as we get it all a little bit more confirmed. Push time now from Viva. They're looking towards the tier 2 tower in the top lane. Same time as AL is moving down towards the bottom lane, but AL doesn't have a creep wave with them. So pushing is a lot more concerning. But it's the tier 2 tower, and they're well out of position. So they go for the tier 3s. Wise thing. Only thing they can do. Attack the tower before the regeneration will start to kick in. Shockwave the creep wave down. So tier 3 for a tier 2. That's meant to be the trade here. TP support's already coming back. Force out that fight. Strang B a little bit further back. Ryan's able to get his Blink Dagger in just before this fight's going to begin. Fatal Bond's up on Syndrome. And Enfeebled. What else needs to happen to Synd to make his life hard? Tier 2 tower's gone on the top lane. Everyone's back for Viva. And that Tier 3 tower is down on half life. Tier 2 tower on the top lane, untouched. Bottom tower, touched slightly. But in a good way. And then the movements from Ryzen Synd. Desolator Armlet. What else is Synd going to be buying up? Nothing on the courier for now. Must be happy with what he's got. Needs to find another creep there for that Hand of Midas. The Thibaut Roshan again. Just over 2 minutes for it. But they're being watched everywhere they go. Sentry wards, even if one person from Viva walk down here, they will see that Dire Observer ward. I think it's just out of range of it too, because you get that normal vision in this little circle here. And then Sentry Ward disappears, so not going to help him out anymore. Yeah, Tier 2 tower, trade time. Top lane Miracle, long way out again. And you can see him trying to get to that Scythe of Ice. He wants an extra Hex up his sleeve. He wants it. Don't know if he'll be successful, though. Well, we got our movement coming in. Hello, Sage's Mask. Maybe possibility for a Yule Scepter when he gets initiated on. Be one way of taking out the SK too. If you're running low on disables, add a Yule Scepter to the mix. SK didn't go BKB, so he's still very susceptible to that. And if he does just come in with the Epicenter, which is more than likely because he's already got the Blink Dagger up and running, then just Yule Scepter yourself out. Take minimal to probably none of the damage depending on your timing of it. Might even dispel some of these abilities, because Yule Scepter will take off the effects of the Curse of the Silent. So one way to free yourself, free your mind. Mag. Roshan's up in like 20 seconds from now. Cinderin's too early. The Empower is still on him too, but he's going to need a refresher in a moment. Because this Roshan attempt's going to take him a little bit longer. Yeah, see. Already doing up on him. Hearing a Coddle pull in. Extra blast already happening. Cinderin. Dude, you can see it. Yeah, there you go. Move off to the side. Roshan spawns up now. So back into the pit. Standing up on Roshan. This is okay. Just got to keep that Hawk away from the engagement. If that happens, did he kill it? Nope. Hawk's still just running around. If that Hawk sees what was happening with Roshan, then it's over for AL. They're keeping their two big teamfight heroes up here on the high ground so they can jump themselves in this direction to nail here. And in the meantime, Miracle can walk over, stand on the high ground, throw out his curse, go the global silence when required, and then Ryze will just want to steal something nice, probably rocks. And just enjoy the time. And remember too, Ryze will take the full power of the Warlock's ulti with the Aghanim Scepter buff as well. When you steal an ability, you steal... Oh, man, Burrow strike in. They're only going on the Bane, however. And then the rocks to fall in. Rice, where's that steal? What did he get? He got the rocks. He got the rocks. The rocks are returned. Two big hits out. They've already lost, however, two heroes. Forced to buy back three heroes on the sidelines. Man, what happens when you get Fatal Bonds and you get locked in the middle of a bloody team fight? The Gyro is just letting a call down, flank cannon, whatever else he's got, loose. And he's got Demon Edge, and then you feed the two rocks. Oh, man, AL. I don't know why they initiated. They should have been counter-initiated. They're going to go again. Blink in, skewer, tries to pull two heroes back, successful at doing so. Able to bring him down, the Epicenter just goes on the reeling over corpse of the SK. The Bane and Coddle being brought down, and Syndrome really wants this Aegis back in again. Buybacks are available. But actually, no, they're not. Not for these heroes that are dead. And there's the Aegis. So again, given to Miracle. So at least there is one thing that AL get from that. But that was such a cluster there. I don't understand why Bane is here. You know the enemy has the high ground across here and can quite easily attack you this direction. So what do? You come down the hill and you chase away from your high ground to get caught into this box here. Even with your team fights, you can't repair that kind of a disadvantage that you put yourself into. Well, they tried it. Didn't work. And we go 15 for 12 now. 35 minutes in. Miracle just wants some space. Some space to farm. Same with Syndrome. 2.8k. Sakura's will be nice, but he needs Monkey King Bar. Especially look at Gyro. Man, Butterfly Evasion, but it all goes into damage. Don't need no heart. He'll sell that Ring of Aquila later on after he finishes up the full Daedalus. Which he just did. So full Daedalus now flies out. And he'll move himself into a Helm of the Dominator. And then go into Satanic. He's already got enough damage to support it. What a mad get. He probably wanted to have an Orchid, an Oblivion Staff, but with the buyback, he's been forced to go into a Ghost Scepter instead. Now the push on bottom lane. Cinderin now, yes. Monkey King Bar starting up. Oh, slow him down, curse him, skewer back out. Ghost Scepter or not, that's going to wear off fast enough, and then even Fae Bolt Shockwave. Wait till he comes out, Lifesteal will take his life. And Bane's on the sidelines for 44 seconds. No buyback available. They're going to go for Rax. They're going to push fast, though. How much damage can you deal? They're keeping the team fights back again. SK as well as Mag. Oldies are up. Fortification going to go. Fatal Bonds tying up Syndrome as well as Miracle together. So Syndrome, going to be careful how much damage he takes here. Will be reflected back again. But then again, at the same time, it's fine. There's no hero there. Don't need to defend top. Let's keep the stalemate going on the bottom lane. Tier 2 tower on the mid, tier 3 tower on the top will hold it for AL. And Viva can hold it themselves here on the bottom lane. Pushing into a Connor Blast. I kind of wish you all the best of luck with that. But the tower will go down. Fortification was forced to be used. Now Gyro, front lines. He's a better one to initiate on. And Feeble as well as Fatal Bonds on one. Oh, no, sorry. He got it to Mag as well. Rocket. People attack the rocket. Attack the rocket. 2200 for the Way of Nakes. Getting closer to that Monkey King Bar. Bit by bit, little by little. Two hits! Two hits with a flat cannon and with the Daedalus and Butterfly. That's basically gone. Is Curry going to buy himself anything nice? Is going by the secret shop? Nope. AL falling back again. Remember, they've still got this Aegis the Immortal. Over on Miracle. Looks like they're giving up. They don't want to play in a stalemate. There's lanes to push out. Viva might be holding inside their base, but only because their Rax was under pressure. It's the only reason. They don't feel like insecure about moving out, but they do definitely feel insecure if they're going to be fighting 4v5 up against AL. There we go, Monkey King bar done. So now there is something that can kill off Gyro. But, at the same time, as we said before, lifesteal for Gyro. It's coming his way. The only hope they have is that these mini bashes from the Monkey King bar lock him in. And those ultis from AL don't go into a bad position. We'll find out. Smoke and Goat. They look for an opening. Beastmaster already clearing off the trees, and they'll see a couple of trees going down, so they know he's here. But they've also got to know that the Hawk is there too. Yep, just disappeared. And Miracle attacked out of the smoke, and then the Hawk kills over. And still, how do you push up against a Coddle and a Warlock? Because Coddle Blast basically blasts out this. Then you got Warlock that drops an ulti in here. And then you got Gyro that'll do the same thing in this, like, death ball. And you try and push in and take out the Rax. Quick curse. Okay, you got him on Bane. Both last word. As well as the curse of the silent. So Bane will be a little bit frustrated, but he can just go back to base and heal up. That's no problem. Make charge already coming out. And Miracle cops the edge of the damage. Good thing he's got that Scythe of Vice as well as Rod of Atos. Radiant's top tower as he switches them around. That helps him with that mana regen. 15 regen per second. Front line. Well, he could try and bait it out with Curse of the Sun on Gyro, but he'll just pop a rocket, so it's fine for Gyro. Helm the Dominated Nair is now dumb. Radiant's top so we increase the armor. Increase the normal HP regen. And once again, AL find themselves in this standoff position. You can see right there, SK wants to go in. He seriously wants to go in. But he cannot do it. And they're being watched as well. Preparation wards are already there, both observers and sentries. I believe they should see down. Yeah, they'll see it. They'll see this ward right here. Radiance top tower. So there's no point trying to loop in around behind AL. But AL also realized there's no point just like hanging out of sight. And again, we hit that point where the Aegis the Immortal, it doesn't go, it gets reclaimed. As in, it doesn't pop, it gets reclaimed. I think the only person who has popped the Aegis the Immortal so far is actually Viva. Viva had one of the heroes. Brain is short-term memory loss. Lost. It's lost forever, peoples. Lost forever. It's coming out in the courier. Two more Go Scepters. And the Oblivion Staff.
Oblivion Staff.
But that's Mags. And Mags still needs more time. Because there's no point holding on to that. Unless you're going to drop something else for it. Bottle for Wand. Bracer. Well, he dropped the bottle. And dropped the wand. What the hell? What did he do to the wand? He dropped the bottle and then, hang on. Picked up a Ghost Scepter as well. I know what he ended up getting, but I'm not quite sure what he sacrificed to get it. No, Wanda's still there. Yeah. Yeah, he had a Ghost Scepter. Yeah, never mind. Going crazy. So 42 minutes in. Again, AL. They just keep knocking on this bottom door. Easiest way to get through. Tier 3 tower's gone. But fortification back up again. So even if they do break it in, it's not going to be fast enough. And you see Coddle. He's actually next to Gyro, the fastest pusher out. But they don't want to risk Gyro by having him so far out from his own base. So leave him on the bottom lane. Still finds the farm on the bot. Cleans it up. Easy as pie. And the Coddle Blast is a quick push too. Means minimal to no damage at all. Coming the way of the Radiant Creep Wave. So it gains good momentum. So basically this is going to be a double Creep Wave. Pushing through the top lane with a Siege Creep in tow. Which is exactly what Viva want. Might also mean that someone has to head towards the top lane and deal with this before Roshan spawns up in a minute. I got a funny feeling that's where Mag wants to head now. And that's good farm that he requires. Without it, he won't get towards that refresher orb. We won't have that double RP from him. They still want to have a crack. Viva on the way out. And the Hawk always to scout. Keep the vision on the other side of the tree line. Make sure they know what they're up against. And Nyx. Enough for buyback even after death. Everyone should probably have that by this point. No, Silencer, Coddle as well as Nyx. They're the only ones. Money was spent on items here for the Gyro. Encourages flew in some new stuff. So what do we get? Well, Beastmaster, we got 4-star from him. Aghanim Scepter looking for a refresher. Already here from the Warlock. Still hasn't hit that level 16 because been grouped up as 5 the entire time. And the advantage keeps going the way of LAL the entire time as well. Which is the most ridiculous thing of all. The most ridiculous thing of all is the fact that Viva can still take the team fight because they have the power. They have the raw damage that comes out from this guy. And he can wipe out the entire AL side in the space of 6 shots. Maybe not Nyx. Cottabas will fly. They know he's over here. Cinderin gets revealed. Up they come. Now the opening. Now the opening. They've got to kill off the Gyro. Down to already two-thirds of his life points. Nice silence. In comes the Epicenter. Beastmaster let off the roar. They bring down one, but it costs them an ultimate. And now they're going to find two. Bane, you can try and hide inside the ghost. They're Fiendscripting up Cinderin. And then Fiendscript stolen. The rock to fall down. Got to be careful about this. Miracle copying a lot of damage. Also from the fact that he's tethered up to Ryze through the Fatal Bonds. And these rocks just keep beating them down. Reverse polarity, shockwave through. Double kill now for Cinderin. Just sitting in the middle of it, gets rid of these damn rocks. And then buyback, Warlock, buyback, Gyro. Again, AL want to go in for Roshan. This time, cheese available.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And they can't decide. Do we go in? Are we there? We don't know. Have a look. Have a look. Nope, no one's coming out. And they can see in. Hawk is up. They know what's going. Oh, steal it. They're going to try it. There's no RP. There's no epicenter. They're going to man fight this. Miracle ulti on cooldown. Roshan at 1/3 of his life. Upheaval. Ah, the curse, the silence, and brain. Mopped up, and then the Burrow Strike. Judo, no! Double kill for Cinderin. Then the chickens. Obi-Wan Bananen. Goes Scepter to run away a little bit faster, but mech charge, Burrow Strike. Sandstorm, triple kill for Cinderin. And back into Rosh. And now is Viva on the sidelines. Buyback's missing from a lot of people. Miracle takes the Akers Immortal, even though he's got so little life. Oh, he's getting it from own charges. And there's also the cheese. Who took the cheese? Cheese with Mag. That'll help him with his refresher. Both mana as well as the health come back with that. His ulti is very, very simple for him now. Spam off everything. Stick around a little bit longer. And then have another crack.
I'm in your debt.
So in we go. Coddle Blast and Cinderin already bringing down the Rax. Shockwave through that ball. And the Rax is gone. They won't want to fight until Gyro's back up. Remember, he's the man that does the damage. And they need the man to do the damage. I'll have to use Fortification for this mid-Rax. Use it now. Yep. Save the time on the tower. Enfeeble. Take a fair chunk of the damage away from Cinderin. The Miracle, even from the low ground, is doing a lot. Needs one person too close. And there it is, Rod of Atos, slowing down the Keeper of the Light. Cinderin, however, Fiendscripted up. There goes the Global Silence. Pull him back in again. Reverse Polarity! Picks up Judo. Refresher. Second Reverse Polarity. And Judo just being held in position while Cinderin beats the crap out of him. And that's going to be a pick-up pushback. Nice Cuddle Blast. With everyone down from Viva. And GG well played. They held the advantage the entire way, but it did not feel as convincing as the graph makes it look. Good game at the end of the day, so Absolute Legends will play in the Grand Final on Tuesday evening. That'll be happening, if I just check my calendar. That'll be happening at 19 CET on Tuesday night, I believe. Unless something changes, but as always, keep your eyes over on Join Dota. Easiest way to work out if something is going to change or not. But tomorrow night, the live stream will return at 16:30 CET. And that's going to be setting off with Rock's Kiss going up against No Tidehunter. Got some fun games for you tomorrow in Star Ladder. In fact, I'm just looking at my confirmed thing. So it's Rock's Kiss versus No Tide at 16:30. 17:30, 3D Clan going up against Fnatic EU. And then Virtus Pro going up against No Tidehunter. And then at 21 CET. So it'll be about an hour break between both Star Ladder as well as the defense. It's just the second game of the night. And it's the All-American Affair. Evil Genius going up against Team Liquid. It is our lower bracket final playoff matchup. To see who can go through into our first final in the lower bracket of the defense. That's right, we're actually getting closer to the end of the defense. It keeps limping itself along with so many tournaments around. Scheduling has been difficult, but we are basically there. So thanks for watching, guys. Remember, rebroadcast will begin in just a couple of moments' time, unless you're watching the rebroadcast, at which point it's about 6 a.m. in the morning for people over here in Europe, and it'll probably be about maybe, well, just before midnight over in America. So yeah, anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you tomorrow for the Star Ladder competition as well as the defense. See you then.